Good morning friends, today we are going to start the last unit of this paper, Surface Chemistry, along with the second part of this unit, the colloidal state. In the surface chemistry, we have to talk about the adsorption, physical and the chemical adsorption, types of the adsorption isotherm, Langmuir's adsorption isotherm, its postulates and the derivation, Beete equation for the multilayer adsorption, derivation not expected, determination of the surface area of an adsorbent using the Beete equation. Then we have to talk about the colloidal state, introduction to the colloids, emulsion, gels and the salts, electrical properties, their origin of the charge on the colloidal particle, concept of the electrical double layer, zeta potential, Helmholtz and the Stern model, electrokinetic phenomena, we have to see the electrophoresis, electrophosphorus, streaming potential, sedimentation potential, donor membrane equilibrium. Third part we have to see colloidal electrolytes, its introduction, micellar formation. Then last part is the surfactants, its classification, application of the surfactants in the detergents and the food industry. This much part we have to cover under this unit. We will start with this particular first part of this unit, surface chemistry. We will see the basic terms that are used in the case of the surface chemistry. Name itself indicates that we will study the surface phenomena, means the adsorption. What is adsorbate? What is adsorption? What is adsorbate? That we have to see. Adsorbent is nothing but the substance on the surface. The substance on the surface of which adsorption occurs is known as the adsorbent. Example, in the adsorption of the ammonia on the activated charcoal act as an adsorbent. Other example, adsorbent in silica gel, alumina, platinum, palladium, nickel, etc. Then what is adsorption? Adsorption is nothing but the surface phenomena in which the substance collects or concentrates on the surface of another substance. Adsorption may be defined as the existence of higher concentration of a substance on the surface of another substance then it is present in the bulk of the substance. Any one definition you can remember, it just nothing but the surface phenomena in which the substance deposited or say collected or say concentrated on the surface of the another substance. That is a very simple definition. Then what is adsorbate? The substance which gets adsorbed on the surface of another substance is called as adsorbate. In the adsorption of the hydrogen on the nickel, hydrogen acts as a adsorbate, whereas ammonia adsorbs on the charcoal, ammonia will be the adsorbate. Then what is the desorption? Exact reverse process will be there. The process of the removal of the adsorbed substance from the surface of the adsorbent is called as the desorption. Means we are removing that. We are removing that part. Then what is the sorption? The process which makes it difficult to distinguish between the adsorption and absorption is known as the sorption. The process which makes it difficult to distinguish between the adsorption and absorption is known as the sorption. Then what is absorption? It is a phenomenon in which the substance is not only retained on the surface but passes through the surface and get distributed throughout the solid or liquid body. That is the absorption, means completely going inside that particular substance, not returning on the surface. Heat of adsorption. The amount of heat evolved per moles of the adsorbed is called heat of adsorption. That is very much important. The amount of heat evolved per mole of the adsorbed is called as the heat of adsorption. You got these basic terms. Then we will move towards the adsorption isotherm of the ammonia and the charcoal. You can see the adsorption of ammonia is different at the different temperature. In figure, V adsorption volume of the gas at sub per unit mass of the adsorbent at pressure P. P is nothing but a stress asset. P0 is the saturated vapor pressure at the experimental temperature. That is pressure required to condense the gas to liquid. Any solid is capable of adsorbing a certain amount of the gas. The extent of the adsorption and equilibrium on equilibrium depends on temperature, pressure of the gas and the effective surface area of the solid. Adsorption increases with increasing pressure and decreasing in temperature. In above figure, the quantity of ammonia absorbed by charcoal at various pressure and the temperature are shown. It is observed that the adsorption of ammonia is maximum at low temperature and high pressure. According to the Le-Chatelier principle, the decrease in the temperature favors exothermic process. Since the adsorption is favored by the decrease in temperature, it must be exothermic. Then types of the adsorption. There are the two types of the adsorption. One will be the physical adsorption, that is also called as the physisorption or van der Waals adsorption, and one is the chemical adsorption or chemisorption or activated adsorption. The difference between the physical and the chemical adsorption we will see. Physical adsorption involves the physical forces like the van der Waals forces, and chemical adsorption involves the chemical forces, that is the transfer of the electrons between the adsorbent and the adsorbent. Then physical adsorption, heat of adsorption is generally less than the 40 kilojoule per mole. And here heat of adsorption varies in between 40 to 400 kilojoule per mole. Then physical adsorption is reversible. It is irreversible, it is not reversible. It is not specific, it is often specific. Activation energy is low activation energy. High activation energy is involved. It is a fast process, it is usually slow process. Adsorption is appreciable at low temperature and high pressure here. It is favored at higher temperature. Decrease of pressure does not cause desorption. Multilayer of adsorbent molecule are formed under high pressure. Only monolayer of the adsorbent molecule are formed on the surface. Then it is general phenomena which occurs in gas solid system under the suitable condition of the temperature and the pressure. It can occur if the gas is capable of forming the chemical bond with the surface structural unit of solid. These are the certain distinguish point that we have to write under this, distinguish between this particular thing. What we have seen, first of all we have talked about the few terms, that is adsorbent, adsorbate, adsorption, desorption. What is adsorbent? The substance on the surface of which the adsorption occurs is known as the adsorbent. Here example is given, adsorption of ammonia and the activated charcoal. Activated charcoal will act as the adsorbent, whereas ammonia is nothing but the adsorbent. The substance which gets adsorbed on the surface of the another substance is called as the adsorbate. Different example that we have seen. Then adsorption, it is nothing but a surface phenomenon in which the substance collect or say concentrate or say deposited on the surface of the another substance. Then we talk about the desorption. The process of removal of the adsorbed substance from the surface of the adsorbent is called as the desorption. Desorption, when the process which makes it difficult to distinguish between the adsorption and absorption is known as the sorption. Means adsorption and absorption collectively call it the sorption. Then what is absorption? In which the substance, the process in which the, or the phenomenon in which the substance not only retain on the surface but also passes through the surface and get activated throughout the cellular liquid body is called as the absorption. Then heat of adsorption, the amount of the heat evolved per mole of the adsorbent adsorbed is called heat of adsorption. Very simple. This amount of the heat evolved per mole of the adsorbent adsorbed is called as the heat of adsorption. Then we talk about the adsorption isotherm of the ammonia gas on the charcoal, activated charcoal. Here we have plotted the diagram of the adsorption versus the pressure P. Means volume adsorbed, volume of gas adsorbed per unit mass of the adsorbent at pressure P. P0 is the saturated vapor pressure at the experimental temperature. We can see here at lower temperature, at higher pressure, there is a more adsorption, whereas at the higher temperature, there is a less adsorption that you have to see. Here given, that is again the same. Any solid is capable of adsorbing a certain amount of the gas. The extent of the adsorption on equilibrium depends on temperature, pressure of the gas and the effective surface area of the solid. Then adsorption increases with increase in pressure and decrease in temperature. In above figure, we have seen that quantity of the ammonia adsorbed by the charcoal at various pressure and temperature ratio. It is observed that adsorption of ammonia is maximum at low temperature and a high pressure. According to Lee-Chatterley principle, decrease in temperature favors the exothermic process. Since the adsorption is favored by the decrease in temperature, it must be exothermic process. Why adsorption is exothermic pressure? Because according to Lee-Chatterley principle, the decrease in the temperature favors the exothermic process. Since adsorption is favored by the decrease in temperature, that's why it is a exothermic in the process. Then types of the adsorption. Two types: physical adsorption, physisorption or van der Waals adsorption, and second one is the chemical adsorption or say chemisorption or activated adsorption. Distinguish the 5 marks question may come in the exam. Distinguish between the physical adsorption and the chemical adsorption. At that time 5 points here and the 5 points there you have to write. In the physical adsorption it involves the physical force, that is the van der Waals forces. In the chemical adsorption it involves the chemical forces, that is the transfer of electron between the adsorbent and adsorbent. In the physical side, heat of adsorption is generally less than 40 kJ per mole. Here the heat of adsorption will lies in between the 40 to 400 kJ per mole. Then physical adsorption is reversible, whereas chemical adsorption is irreversible. Okay, then physical adsorption is not specific, but chemical adsorption is often specific. Activation energy is low in case of the physical adsorption, whereas high activation energy is involved in this particular chemical adsorption. Then it is a fast process, it is a usually slow process. Adsorption is appreciable at low temperature and high pressure. Then it is favored at a higher temperature. Decrease of pressure does not cause desorption. Multilayer adsorbent molecules are formed under the high pressure, whereas monolayer will be here in only the chemical adsorption. It is a general phenomena which occurs in the gas solid system under the suitable conditions of temperature and pressure. Here it can occur only if the gas is capable of forming chemical bond with the surface structural units of the solid. Here we have seen this part. Please read this part very well. If you have any problem, any query, you can really ask. Please go through this lecture. If you are not getting the any term, you can really ask on the Google Classroom or say WhatsApp group. Okay, please daily go through this lecture. If you are not going with this daily lectures, then it is very difficult to remember. It is very difficult to understand this concept. If you are following this lecture daily, then it is very simple or very easy to clear the doubts. Okay, today we will stop here. Thank you.